My research is all about brains. They're fascinating things on many levels. Because our brains are so complex, unfortunately, they tend to go wrong. So if we can understand how they work, then perhaps we can fix them. And my research program is really focused on understanding how different parts of the brain, which process different types of information, things stored in memory, for example, how's that all coordinated in order to drive behavior? Our particular focus is on the contribution of sleep disruption. So in complex diseases like schizophrenia, for example, even simple decisions can be confounded. We all know that after a rough night's sleep, we tend to be a bit grumpy, to find it a bit harder to make sensible decisions the next day. So there's a growing understanding that sleep disruption in disease is leading to some cognitive impairment. If we can treat that sleep disruption, then of course, perhaps we can improve cognitive function. Now, it's not only in complex diseases like schizophrenia that this sleep impairments manifest. As we age, for example, the nature of our sleep changes. We tend to sleep in shorter bouts, in a more fragmented pattern. And this might contribute, in fact, to a decline in learning and memory function in aging, for example. So this aging aspect is how our collaboration with Nina kicked off.
What I'm really interested in is, how does the brain actually sense, for example, that you've just eaten? How does it know what the metabolic state of the body is? So how does it sense what your energy state is? How does it integrate all that information? And how does it then tell the rest of the body what to do with that information? And as you can imagine, that all goes horribly wrong in diseases like, for example, obesity, where all the sensing, integrating, and adjusting of body weight, food intake goes wrong. And so one of the things that we're very interested in is, how do neurons in the central nervous system, in a particular brain structure called the hypothalamus, how do they actually pick up on the signals from the periphery to sort of tell, okay, I've just stuffed myself with chocolate and my glucose levels are actually incredibly high, or how does it sense that I'm starving, I don't have enough glucose, make me eat more, and then tells me to eat more so I can basically adjust my metabolic state. So on the aging front, one of the things that happens is that the communication between different brain structures obviously breaks down, as Matt has explained. So that's really kind of where our work sort of hooks together, where we're sort of interested in, from a molecular, cellular aspect of energy supply within a neuron, to sort of neuron-to-neuron communication, and then on another level, structure-to-structure communication within the central nervous system.
I guess that's the joy of a building like the medical school, is that you have a systems neuroscience lab like mine next door to a more molecular biology lab like Nina's, then these kind of collaborations tend to blossom.